pick one up, share it, and just share it with friends. So, thank you.
Tonight. We really appreciate you being here. It's a pleasure. lot of workers, women in particular workers, were striking for all sorts of good things, better pay and rights. And, it was called the Running Roses Strike because of the speech that was given by one of the union activists, a woman named Rose Schneiderman. And she said, "What the woman who labors wants is the right to live, not simply exist. The right to life as the rich woman has the right to life, and the sun, and music, and art. The worker must have bread, but she must have roses too." And so we believe that that sentiment, the concept that it's not enough to have just enough to keep you alive, the sustenance, not enough to only have bread, but that everyone deserves the right to the roses as well, the things that make life worth living. And that is sadly something that still needs to be fought for today. So this is Windborne's arrangement of Bread and Roses. As we go marching, marching in the beauty of the day, a million darkened kitchens, a thousand mill locks gray,
Quince Brigada. And one of the soldiers from that group took an old Spanish folk song and rewrote the words to it, like as happens with so many folk songs. And then this song, Viva la Quince Brigada, was popularized in the English-speaking world through the singing of Pete Seeger, of course. And it's a song with a really powerful message. The verses say things like, our only wish is to take down fascism. We fight against the mercenaries, the traitors, the fascists. And in particular, the last verse jumped out at us. It says, now we're leaving Spain to fight on other fronts. And for us, this really speaks to the fact that the fight against bigotry and hate and fear is one that's been going on for many generations, and it's now ours to carry into the future. So this is one of the newest additions to our Song of the Times project, Songs of Social Struggle. Viva la Quince Brigada.
Strongholds for resistance were the Basque nationalists, not only did the Basques have their own culture and music and language and sort of internal social structure that remained independent from the Spanish controlling government, but also they were right on the border with France, and so the fighters of this time could go into Basque country and cross over the border of France where they were in a different country, and so the Spanish government couldn't find them. And we're going to sing you now a song from Basque country, which is not one of these songs that cracks up. It's a story of a travel in the opposite direction. It's from the French side of Basque country, and it's a singer, it's a love song. It's a singer talking to a little bird, saying, "Where are you going, little bird, on your two wings so high through the air? If you're going over the mountains, the high mountains, to Spain, fly there and fly to my love, because I cannot cross the mountains until the snow melts and the high mountain passes. Fly into her heart as she has flown into mine." And I got the great opportunity, after learning this song in 2011 in Basque Country, to return there and actually go to the village where the song is from and sing this with the traditional singer as we drove the path that this bird would take. There's several landmarks that are mentioned in the song that we sort of drove up and through this place, and that was a really special moment. This is Choritua, which is little bird.
So we wrote our own arrangement inspired by them of this song called No Guiatas, and No Guiatas means nine girls. It says, well, the first verse says, there are nine girls in the village of Castanau, and they all want to dance. And then there are some guys, and they're sitting in the shadows in the corner, and they don't want to dance. And the second verse says, there are eight girls in Castanau who want to dance, etc. And then it says seven and six, and it continues. It's a song of attrition. until finally there are none left, and the guys are still sitting in the corner not wanting to dance. We figure that this is the Occitan version of a middle school dance. No, we have a circus.
Yes.
out more information about the food pantry, there's a table at the back. Also, right next to that table, there's our CD table, where we have a bunch of important things. If you didn't hear about this concert directly from us, there's a mailing list back there. We come and we do performances in the greater Boston area fairly regularly. We're based in Western Mass and Southern Vermont, so we're not too far. In particular, I think we're going to be trying to set up a workshop here at the First Parish, doing teaching some of these songs, teaching some of this harmony and this music, the songs of social struggle and some of the songs from other places. So that will be probably sometime this spring. We're not sure exactly when, but keep an eye out for that. The way to find out is the mailing list in the back. Also, back there we have four different CDs. If you liked the last two songs that we sang, they're both on an album called Lay Around That Chap, which is American and English folk song. There's also a sort of sampler album with some Basque stuff, some Occitan stuff, as well as Corsican and Georgian and Bulgarian, and as well as stuff in English. It's from Midwood to Me. There's a trio CD, before I joined the group, the three of them singing trio singing traditions from Corsica, the United States, and the Republic of Georgia. And then finally, of course, there's our current project, which is called Song of the Times, which is songs of social struggle from the past 400 years. And that one, it is a CD, it looks an awful lot like a book. It is also a book. it has beautifully illustrated worksheets of all the songs, so if you're a person who likes reading that, do that. It also has sheet music for the melodies of the songs. It also has essays by a bunch of different guest essayists, really wonderful people, giving some of the historical and cultural context for the movements that the songs come from. So definitely go check it out. That's there in the back as well. Take cash and credit card and checks and all of that. We're going to sing now a song from that album, and this is sort of the reason that we're here for you today. Because while we were putting out this album, we were doing an Indiegogo crowdfunding campaign, and we had a short sort of 30-second clip of us singing one of these songs outside of a particularly shiny tower on Fifth Avenue in New York City. And that went viral, and a million people saw that. If you don't know what I'm talking about, talk to someone next to you, and you probably might have seen that video. So that really got a lot of people interested in what we're doing, and for about a year now, almost a year, we've made this our full-time job, going around and singing bringing this music and this message to audiences around the country and around the world. So we really thank you for being here and supporting us today and for buying CDs that helps us keep doing what we're doing. And the song comes from the 1840s, and it's remained relevant enough that people have added verses over the years and continued in that tradition. The melody is by Ian Robb, it's called Song of the Lower Classes.
We plowed and sowed, we are so low that we delve in the dirty clay, till we bless the plain with gold and grain of the veil the rain retain. Our bliss we know, we are so low down at the landlord's feet. We're
some foreign country. That was yesterday.
Live on hay, you'll get pie in the sky when you die, that's a lie. That's the chorus of the song, so when you pick it up, you can join us. It's called The Picture of the Slave, or Pie in the Sky.
Bye.
Song of the Times project has really given us a chance to look back at really important movements in our history, both of this country and of the world in general. Movements, we're doing really good work that needs continuing sometimes. Our rights didn't come from nowhere, and sometimes they need work to maintain. And one of the movements we thought was really important to include in this project was the abolitionist movement. And while that movement was successful in one way, in abolishing slavery in the legal sense, it did not manage to really get rid of the ideology that supported slavery and the slave trade, the ideology of white supremacy. So there's a lot more work to be done in our society still in that direction. So this song is an abolitionist song from the Southern Appalachians. It's called Stolen Soul. And we added a couple of verses to it to just try to mention a couple of things of the many things that need to be mentioned. So this is Stolen Soul.
Thank you. Shine, it's not a hickory, dark, complete, like, sips of rubber, sack of shimmer, yeah.
traveling people. And it's a album that deals with some of the struggles of Scottish travelers and the lived experience of Scottish travelers, which are a very discriminated group, even today, the science that was new travelers served here. It's really kind of mind-blowing. And this is a song that the political enters sort of around the edges, but ostensibly it's a song about the coming of winter and the harder times to come. It's called The Terror Dark.
Still we grow.
Davy Dawes from the north of England. Jump in, let's pick up the chorus.
I can hear the boys,
love.
have some CDs in the back, and we have our mailing list. If you're interested in hearing more of what we do, we're going to be appearing in Christmas Celtic Sojourn this December. So that's going to be a great time. We had a great time last year, and we got invited back. We were surprised and delighted.
You might hear some of the music that you're tonight there. So
always possible. And it's always a great time to collaborate with some of the best folk musicians really around. And we also want to thank the volunteers tonight for making this happen. We have one more piece for you before we head off, which is a piece from Quebec. And this is called Les Tisserands, which means the weavers. It goes through a sort of the weekly schedule of Quebecois weavers. On Monday, they have a little party and do some drinking. And on Tuesday, they have headaches, so there's not much weaving going on. On Wednesday, it's time to, you know, set up the loom, you put the, you know, threads on. And on Thursday, all right, you've done that part, so you can go off and have a visit with the missus. And then where am I? Friday. Okay, so on Friday, then you do some weaving. And then on Saturday, your piece that you're working on isn't finished yet. So on Sunday, it's time to go to the client and ask for more money. So thank you all so much. This is Les Tisserands. Yes. Les Tisserands font plus que les évêques.
Les Tisserands font plus que les évêques.
Les artistes font-ils de fêtes.
Thank you.
Thank you.